Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I'm going to give you some tips how to interpret the blepsmia. So the first important thing you need to do is after staining, you need to visualize your blepsmia in either 4x or 10x magnification. So you are doing this to ensure that the staining is adequate, and you're also going to check the quality of smear. So a good quality smear will have individual RBCs that is spread apart equally, and you're also going to see the distribution of cells. You will see aggregates of platelets like the one you see in the center, or towards the periphery you will see cluster of leukocytes. So by doing this in 10x, you will know if the blood smear has leukocytosis or does it have platelet aggregates, etc. And also it can tell whether there is a significant erythrocyte clumping or rouleau formation is present or not in the blood smear. So it gives all this information just by looking at the smear in 10x. So I have changed the magnification to 40x, okay. In this magnification, you can see three different things. One is RBC, outline abnormalities, or otherwise called as poikilocytosis. Here you can definitely see how different each and every RBC looks, because in 40x, you get to cover at least 100 to 150 erythrocytes in just one field. So you can precisely tell what are the different shapes you commonly come across, and you can measure the degree of poikilocytosis here. And coming to the leukocytes, you can pretty much tell what type of leukocyte they are, whether they are band neutrophil, whether they are mature neutrophil, or you can easily identify an eosinophil, a monocyte. And you can also spot platelets, although they are very clear in the 100x magnification, but still you can notice platelets like the one you see here. They are little smaller than erythrocytes, but however you can just count how many platelets you see per high power field. And these are the three important things that you can check in 40x magnification. Now I have changed the magnification to oil immersion or 100x. This is where you will see in-depth morphology of erythrocyte, leukocyte and platelet. You can also notice inclusion bodies. They can be inclusion bodies that you see in anemia, such as Heen's body, Havel-Joly bodies. You can also see nucleated RBCs here, and you can see hemoparasites, both intra-erythrocytic and intra-leukocytic. And you can also assess the morphology of platelets. See, in this field you can see the degree of poikilocytosis and degree of anisocytosis, and you can also spot RBCs that have profound hypochromasia. So these are some of the things that you can notice in oil immersion. I hope this video was informative. If you liked it, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more such videos. I'll see you all in a different video. Till then, take care and bye.